So your eye doctor said you have cataracts and you need surgery. What's a cataract and how can you set yourself up for success with surgery? Let me tell you now. All right, so a cataract happens as you age. There's other kinds of cataracts. We're gonna focus on age-related cataracts. A cataract happens when your lens starts to age. Just like the lens of a camera, your eye has a lens that focuses light on the back of your retina. This allows you to see. When that lens starts to age, it starts to turn yellow and starts to be less flexible. This causes your vision to decrease. When a cataract starts to form, you're gonna start to notice glare, halos on lights, and your glasses will always feel like they're dirty. It's like constantly looking through a dirty windshield. Funny story, I once had a patient that had cataracts and he came in and told me that after cataract surgery, it changed his life. He couldn't believe how much more vivid colors were. He told his wife that they needed to get a new washing machine. The reason for this was all of his white shirts were starting to look yellow. The moment he had cataract surgery, he realized the washing machine was fine and that the yellow was from the lens of his eye, not from the clothes not getting clean. When you have cataracts, one of the most frustrating things that happens is glasses or a new prescription will not make you see any better. The reason for this is it's a lack of light getting to the retina that's causing the issue. And when that lens is cloudy or yellowing, light will get deflected in different directions and things are not going to be clear. So, although surgery sounds kind of scary, especially when it's on your eye, realize that although a complex procedure, it has very good outcomes and the majority of patients have a successful surgery. So there are actually things you can do to make sure the surgery goes well. Let me give you three things. All right, number one, not all surgeons are created equal. Yeah, I know. We like to think that every doctor, every optometrist are all good at their jobs. And while every doctor and optometrist has the minimum level of certification to do their job, there are different tiers and you want to go to a surgeon that your eye doctor recommends. They've worked with tons of patients and they see the outcomes. They know who's good, they know who's not as good, and they know your specific situation. So talk to your eye doctor and make sure you listen to their recommendation for your situation. Number two, know your options. Believe it or not, it's not a one-size-fits-all surgery. There's different lens options, different ways to do the procedure. Ask questions. Make sure that you're picking the right choice for your lifestyle. If you don't understand what the surgeon's telling you, you're not doing the surgery that initial consultation day. Make sure you reach out to your optometrist. They can help you answer the questions that might be over your head or you're not sure what's being told to you. So communication is key to having a successful surgery. Number three, you need to optimize your ocular surface. At our office, we do a procedure called ocular surface optimization. This will set you up for success. Your tear film will affect light entering your eye and how it focuses. Now, when you hear the words ocular surface optimization, you may ask yourself, what does that mean? How do I know if my ocular surface is optimized? Well, some symptoms that you may have are red, dry, irritated eyes. If they water a lot, or if you have to blink frequently to make things clear, these are things that are indicating that your ocular surface is not optimized. Additionally, if you have keratoconus or any corneal irregularity, you're going to want to make sure you go to a surgeon that understands the cornea at a higher level. One of the things that we do in our office to maximize the ocular surface is utilizing something called an amniotic membrane. Amniotic membranes are covered by insurance and they're easy, quick ways to make sure that your ocular surface is in the best possible condition for surgery. We even use this for patients that aren't getting cataract surgery and are having a lot of damage to their eyes because of dryness, irritation, or the environment that they're in. When you're doing a complex surgery like cataract surgery, there's a million specific and intricate measurements that are dependent on you having a healthy ocular surface. So make sure that your ocular surface is in the right condition to have the surgery. In addition, your lids and lashes need to be clean and free of bacteria. If you have that bacteria when you go into surgery, you're more likely to get an eye infection that could have negative consequences. So optimizing the ocular surface and making sure your lids and lashes are free of bacteria are essential to having an excellent outcome with cataract surgery. So as you can see, there's a million things we can do to optimize your ocular surface. You just have to talk to your eye doctor and make sure that you select the best possible solution for your specific situation. So if you learned something new, like, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.